What's going on, guys? It's Your Average Consumer, and today Microsoft introduced a ton of new Surface products. So if you like Surface gear, buckle up, because they dropped a lot. So first up, let's talk about the Surface Duo 2, which I'm personally excited to see because I like the Surface Duo. I like the concept. I even like the hardware. And I just feel like this thing is something that Microsoft needs to keep iterating on, making better, because it's got pretty solid bones. So for those of you who don't know, the Surface Duo is a foldable smartphone, but the screens do not fold. The smartphone folds, but it has two screens on each side. Now, I personally think this is like the best multitasking smartphone because you can literally have two full-blown apps open at the same time, no compromising screen real estate or anything like that. But either way, let's talk about what's new here. Now, overall, we've got a pretty similar form factor, but those two screens have a few updates. So now they have a 90 hertz refresh rate, so things should look a bit smoother. It's not quite 120, but 90 hertz is pretty good, and you've got two screens running at that 90 hertz at the same time. And with that 90 hertz display, gaming on this phone should look even cleaner. And surprisingly, Microsoft actually showed some dual screen gaming, kind of reminiscent of like the Nintendo 3DS. I was pretty surprised to see that. I believe they're gonna have a few game titles coming out that support two screens, so basically Nintendo 3DS style kind of action, but with much cleaner, bigger displays. So I'm very interested in that. Now, something else you'll notice with the screens is that they've actually got a bit of a lip. So when it's closed, you can see lights on the side to let you know when you've got like notifications. And you can even see how many messages or missed calls you have on the side. It's a small screen, but things are definitely visible. So if you don't want to pick up your phone and check it, you can still see what's going on, what kind of things you're missing, which is kind of nice because with this kind of design, you can't exactly have an always on display to give you your notifications. And they even upped the processing power with the Snapdragon 888 chip. So you've got the latest and greatest from Qualcomm, not to mention the addition of 5G. You also notice in the back, it gained quite the camera bump. Literally, it's got a triple camera system now with a wide, ultra wide, and telephoto lens. And I gotta say, from what I've seen so far, just in person, testing it for just like a few minutes, the quality looks substantially improved. So, got better cameras there. We got the new triple camera system, got the big camera bump in the back. So, I can't wait to give that a full test. But so far, it looks pretty promising. And you might have noticed we've also got a new color. We've got Glacier and Obsidian, so white, black. The black or obsidian looks really clean. Now, something else that's new to the Surface Duo 2 is support for the Microsoft Slim Pen 2, which was also freshly announced, which is Microsoft's newer Slim Pen, which we originally saw come out with the Microsoft Surface Pro X. Now, the Duo 2 is going to support the newest version, and get this, it can even be magnetically attached to the Duo 2 and it'll charge it at the same time. Pretty cool stuff, but we can't stay on the Duo too long. There are a lot of other products. And of course, Microsoft updated the Surface Pro lineup, so we now have the new Surface Pro 8. And the Surface Pro 8 has a pretty new design. We've got a slightly larger display with smaller bezels, rounded edges, which kind of remind me of the Surface Pro X. But one thing that I'm super, super happy about is they've added support for Thunderbolt. So now we have two Thunderbolt ports on the side, which changes everything. So this is a portable device, which now supports Thunderbolt, meaning you can add an external GPU. So if you want to game on this, the possibility is absolutely there. Not to mention, it has a 120 hertz display, so you'll even be able to play with some pretty good frame rates. So this is actually really exciting to me. They've also updated the keyboard, so it now holds the Surface Slim Pen 2. So just like we saw with the Surface Pro X, that feature has now come over to the Surface Pro lineup. And if you've been on the fence about the Surface Pro, I feel like now is the time to get one. It's looking really good. Now, they've also introduced the Surface Go 3, which has that smaller form factor, but it now has LTE. So if you want to be able to take that small form factor just about anywhere, you'll be able to do that as well. Now, those are cool and all, but the product that blew my mind is the Surface Laptop Studio, a completely new laptop in the Surface lineup that actually replaces the Surface Book. I'm gonna miss that, but the Surface Laptop Studio is crazy. This thing is pretty much all of the Surface products we've pretty much ever seen turned into one. Now, initially, this thing has a pretty standard laptop look, but it can do so much more. That screen, which is also 120 hertz, can actually be adjusted. So you can take the screen, prop it forward. It can kind of lean back like the Surface Pro, but you still get access to the trackpad. And then you can take it one step further and put it all the way down like we've seen with the Surface Studio. But if you still want all screen, but you don't want to have it in that like tablet-like mode, you can completely reverse the screen so that it's facing the back and you've got all tablet while still leaning up using the keyboard. It's a lot of stuff to unpack there, guys. Lots of different form factors within one product, within one laptop, which is unlike anything we've seen before. Now, this laptop also has a spot on the bottom for the Surface Slim Pen 2, which magnetically attaches, so you have access to that whenever you want it. Now, we didn't talk too much about the pen earlier, but the Surface Slim Pen 2 actually has some new upgrades. It has this haptic feedback, so it feels like you're actually using it on a piece of paper. And I gotta say, so far from what I've seen, it feels pretty legit. It's actually really surprising. And you'll get that same sensation on the Surface Pro as well. And you can pretty much see at the bottom of the laptop, it's got this pretty interesting design. It's got like the full laptop layer, and then it's like a second layer underneath it, which is a little bit smaller. That's where this thing has like all of its vents so the heat can come out. I was a little concerned with this design at first, thinking if the edges are wider than the platform that it's on, it's gonna be a little bit wobbly on the corners. But it was not wobbly by any means whatsoever. Even putting some pressure on the corners, that thing did not budge, so it is pretty secure. It is not a design that we're used to seeing, but as of right now, I don't think there are any real compromises, but I can't say for sure until I get it in hand and actually test it. And this is a 14-inch display, and I'll throw up some of the specs so that you guys can see exactly what it's working with. Now, this laptop also has two Thunderbolt 4 ports, so if you want to have Thunderbolt accessories, you can do that. If you want to add an external GPU or something, you can do that. But thankfully, this guy also has a dedicated graphics card. This thing's gonna be packing the NVIDIA RTX 3050 Ti, as well as having Intel's 11th generation i5 and i7 processors, depending on what you need. So it's going to be a completely capable machine. It's supposed to be the jack of all trades. It should be able to handle just about anything, whether you're doing artistic work, you wanna do some gaming, you wanna just do professional work, content consumption. This is like an all-around beast that should just be able to handle anything you throw at it. So this laptop right here, guys, is one that I am extremely excited for. It seems that it can do just a bit of everything. It has all these different form factors, so you can use this pretty much however you want. Now, in terms of other specs, this thing has Microsoft's quad Omnisonic speakers, dual far-field studio microphone so that you can have clearer audio, as well as a 1080p camera, which actually supports having a mask on. You guys can see I've got my hat, mask on, and it still recognizes my face, which is great because when you're on conference calls or something and you've got all kinds of lighting situations, it's gonna be able to focus on you and make sure you have the best lighting situations for those calls. It'll also have Wi-Fi 6, go up to 32 gigs of RAM, and even up to 2 terabytes of storage. I personally think it's crazy to be able to have a screen that moves like that. Even the cables are like these ribbons so that it's still super flat and able to be flexible. Like it's insane. But I wanna know what you guys think with a comment down below. Now, Microsoft also updated their Surface Pro X, which is their ARM chip lineup. That one is going to now have a Wi-Fi only version alongside the Gigabit LTE version. And it also now has a starting price point at $899. And we're also gonna be seeing improved app support with this model. And since this is an ARM chip, sometimes you gotta think about, will this application work with this laptop? And it should offer a lot more support. Now, Microsoft also introduced a couple of other cool things like their Surface Adaptive Kit, which basically allows you to interact with your laptop a little bit better, especially for those who might have disabilities. They offer different little things like tabs and markers so that you know exactly what you're pressing, or maybe even just opening the laptop a bit easier. Lots of cool stuff there. They've also got this ocean plastic mouse, which is completely made from recycled materials gathered from the ocean. Now, this one is really cool, not only because of the beautiful teal accents, but it's actually made from resin, which is gonna be completely different on each mouse, so no mouse will look the same. It's a part of their recycling program where you can even take your old mouse that doesn't work anymore, put it in the box, and ship it back so that it can get recycled properly. Pretty cool stuff. But that was a quick rundown of everything that is coming to the Surface lineup. Let me know what you guys think with a comment down below. I'm glad to see the Surface Slim Pen make its way across other devices, and I'm super glad to see that Surface Laptop Studio is a thing. I'll try to put links to everything down below in the description so that you guys can learn more than what you got in this video. But that about wraps it up. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, be the cool guy or girl that gives this video a thumbs up, and I'm gonna catch you guys in the next one. Till then, it's your average consumer. Peace.